Hey, what is up, guys? Welcome to RAM Overload. Today I'm going to be talking about what the top 5 screen sharing softwares are in my opinion. Okay, so this list is not in any specific order, it's just the top 5. So the first one I want to talk about is ShareX. So ShareX is a screen capture, file sharing, and productivity tool, like it says over here, and it's really good. You can check out the screenshots and see for yourself. So it does come with a lot of options, right? The interface is good at what it does, but it could be simplified. You know, one thing I do find the problem with this is that it does a lot of things, but the interface isn't really handling that well. Like there's just too many options to do, right? And there's kind of like a steep learning curve, but like once you learn it, it's relatively easy to use. That's why in my opinion it's on my list. But it is, you know, feature rich and does provide some great features when taking a screenshot. You know, obviously if you just want something like a simple screenshot, this is kind of like overkill. But then again, you know, if you want to do something more, and you know, you might not even know what features these has, and you can definitely check it out and see for yourself. So yeah, besides a mildly steep learning curve, you know, it is kind of required, especially when editing the software. Well, when editing the screenshot, I should say, that's where the steep learning curve is. But if you're just taking regular screenshots, then it shouldn't be too difficult to get set up. All right. So that's the first one. Second one I want to talk about is GreenShot. So GreenShot is a user-friendly screenshot program and that gives you the basic utilities you need. It's simple, but it's very useful in my opinion. So, like, you know, there's other popular programs to take screenshots when you press print screen, and this also does that as well. So you can press print screen and it will open up the tool that to take a screenshot. Okay, so this is very similar to a regular simple screenshot program, right? Which I will talk about later on, but it does have some more features in it. Okay, the interface, in my opinion, is well, right? I don't know why they have it like this, but the interface is, in my opinion, pretty good. It's not too much like the previous one, ShareX, that I was talking about, but it's just right amount to have, especially features as well. Okay, in terms of editing options, there are some editing options that are fairly simple, like cropping, annotating, resizing, flipping, which in my opinion is kind of all you really need when taking a screenshot. You know, you really don't need all that other feature stuff, editing stuff in it, because it's just kind of overkill. At that point, it's more of a photo editing software, right? Kind of like a mini Photoshop or something like that. So you really just need like crop, annotate, resize, and flipping, okay? Which this provides out of the box. And also, I want to mention there are sharing capabilities. You can upload your image directly to Imgur. Right, Imgur, which is a popular site to like share images and stuff, or you can email it to someone, and you know, those are the two sharing options that it comes with. It would be better if you could like kind of automatically upload it to like some kind of drive, right? Whether it's like Dropbox or Google or something like that, but other than that, this is really good. Performance wise, it's really good in my opinion. Performance is probably better than any other software out there, right? It's not heavy on anything and it doesn't lag, make your computer lag at all. So the third one we want to talk about is Markup Hero. So Markup Hero is more of a, I would say, a regular desktop application in a sense that you would see when editing. The other ones are kind of different. But Markup Hero works on all platforms, so you know it can work on Windows, Mac, Linux, and even if you have a Chromebook or something like a Chrome extension, they have that for there as well. They do have a free version as well as a paid version, right? $4 a month, which is pretty cheap. But then again, it's, you know, it really depends on whether you actually need it or not. In my opinion, I think the free one does just as good, you know, whatever you want, the free one has available. I never really went into purchasing the premium one, but you know, for some people who need more features, then go for it. But as you guys can see over here, features, these are all the different features that it has. It's really feature rich, right? And then it also provides some great integrations, right? So this one is more, you would see people who have, I guess, businesses or something like that, like a small business or whatnot, you know, use this kind of for them, because it also integrates easily with Slack or any kind of API, right? Which is very useful when you want to create or do something automated, right? So yeah, other than that, the reviews are great. In terms of performance, it's really good. It's lightweight, no heavy thing on your desktop or anything, right? The interface is really simple. Let me just pull it back up over here. So you can see the interface is pretty good. You can do by pages, the options on top. You know, it's not a steep learning curve or anything. In my opinion, it's really easy to use, and any beginner can get started with it and, you know, just start using it out the box. So now the fourth one we're going to talk about is Screen Rec, REC. So you can see Work Less, Do More. They are also a screenshot tool, but they also provide screen recording as well. It's lightweight, there's no lag to the screen recorder or the screenshot tool, and it's easy to use interface. You know, that's why, in my opinion, it is kind of the best one out there, especially if you are also interested in taking videos, okay, like screen recordings. So this application is available on Windows, Mac, and Linux. It does say that this is where I don't totally agree with the way they're marketing it. It's kind of kind of shady marketing, where it says get it for free. So you could get it for free, but then once you get it, you will have to pay. They are paying pricing tiers, right? So it's not completely free. You know, obviously you could use it free. The paid one do other things like cloud storage or something like that, right? I really don't use this much anymore, but you know, if you are looking for something for screen recording as well as screen capturing, then you know, definitely look into this as well. Performance wise, it's pretty good. You know, it's really lightweight on your computer, nothing too crazy. It probably won't affect your computer's speed at all. So now moving last one, but definitely not the least one, is Snipping Tool. So Snipping Tool is a built-in program on Windows. So if you have Windows, you will have Snipping Tools, and you know, you've probably used it before. Most people have, but if you haven't, definitely just all you need to do is just search it and you'll see it, right? In my opinion, it's probably one of the best ones out there. It's mainly because every computer has it already, and it's really lightweight and simple. It's really simple to use as well. So let's just bring it up and we can see exactly what features it has. So you guys can see over here, new for a new screen recording, rectangle mode, window, full screen, freeform. And then you can also set a delay, which is definitely helpful in a lot of cases. So let's just show you an example. All right, so now I took a screenshot of that. And we can see over here the editing options that it provides. So highlighting, you know, you can highlight, and then also writing over something, you know. So these are really simple editing options, which in most cases, this is perfectly fine for everyone. This is all you need. You know, you might want to get like a fancy software, which, you know, has features on features. It's crazy feature rich, you know, but then again, that kind of just delays your process on whatever you're doing. You know, there could be a steep learning curve. It could be a distraction. It could cause your computer to lag. So that's why simple, or, you know, just basically what you need is what you should get, right? Or what you should stay with. Okay, if you want a editing tool that does better markup, then this probably isn't for you, because there is no typing option, which in my opinion, definitely should have that as well. Some kind of typing option, or, you know, shapes or something like that. You know, here, if I want to write something, I gotta, you know, write it down, which, you know, it's very difficult to do with the mouse. You know, sharing capabilities is, once you take a screenshot, it's automatically saved to your clipboard, so you can just paste it somewhere, like an email or somewhere, right, a file, and it will automatically save there, right? So that's really good that you can do that as well. So there's really no need to actually save the file. So most of the time, when I take a screenshot, I'm usually sending it to someone, whether it's on like some kind of chatting application or an email. So I can just, when I take the screenshot, it automatically copies. So now I can just paste it in the email or the whichever chatting application I'm using. So yeah, that's pretty much it. You know, these are the top five screenshot tools, in my opinion. You know, let me know what you guys thought. So if you have any other tools that you guys use or recommend, you know, definitely leave it down below. I'd love to check it out. Other than that, make sure to like the video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell. I'll leave a link to all these products in the description below. So definitely check that out. So other than that, yeah, peace out.